Hello students and welcome back. As we have discussed in previous video, today we will be discussing complete exercise of acids, bases and salts. I hope you have watched previous videos carefully. We have covered all the topics of the lesson. Still, if you have any queries, if any doubts are there, feel free to call me and contact me. So let us start. I hope, as in yesterday's description I have given a note, you have to start completing your exercise. I have given the last date of submission of exercise to you. I hope you have started writing answers. Exercise is not big, 11 questions are there. So here we will discuss whole exercise. Here is the first question. State the differences between acids and bases. Now, in one of the worksheet also I have given this question to you. You must have written the answer. So let us again see the differences of acids and bases. Acid turn blue litmus to red. Okay, this is one of the basic property of acids. They turn blue litmus to red, and bases turn red litmus to blue. You have to write these differences. You have to make the table. Two columns you have to make. First column acid, second column base. In first column, first difference you will write. In second column, first difference of bases. Okay. Then second, bases turns red litmus blue. Second difference. Acids are sour in taste, bases are bitter in taste. Third difference, acids give a dark pink color with China rose indicator, bases give dark green color with China rose indicator. So here, these are the three differences. There are many more differences you can write by your own. You can add your own differences. Okay. Now question second. While seeing this video, you can write answers by pausing it, or if you have written the answer, you can check your answers. If your answers are wrong, you can correct the answers. Okay. Question 2. Ammonia is found in many household products such as window cleaners. It turns red litmus blue. What is its nature? I know you all must be knowing the answer. If a litmus turns from red to blue, it means it is basic. Yes, the answer is here. The nature of ammonia is basic. Then question third. Name the source from which litmus solution is obtained. What is the use of this solution? From which source we obtain litmus? In my previous videos, I have told you litmus is a natural indicator, correct? And it is obtained from lichens. Yes. So answer is here. Litmus solution is extracted from lichens. It is used as an indicator to distinguish between bases and acids, correct? So let us go to the fourth question. Is the distilled water acidic, basic or neutral? How would you verify it? Though we have discussed in our video, but what do you think? Do you know what is distilled water, acidic, basic or neutral? If you don't know, how you will test it? How you will identify whether it is acidic or basic or neutral? Let us see the answer. Distilled water is neutral and one can easily test it with the help of litmus paper. When we dip litmus paper in distilled water, there will not be any change in the color. You can test distilled water with the red litmus paper and blue litmus paper. They will not turn their color. They will not change their color. Red will not change its color and blue will also not change its color. Distilled water means what? Do you know what is meant by distilled water? Distilled water contains only water molecules, H2O molecules. What is the formula for water? Chemical formula. Water contains hydrogen and oxygen. Correct. H2, two atoms of hydrogen, one atom of oxygen. So two atoms of hydrogen and one atom of oxygen combine with each other to form one water molecule. Now in distilled water, only these water molecules are present. What water we drink, that is not a distilled water. In that water, like you must be having at your home, RO purifier, correct? So that RO purifier doesn't make impure water into distilled water. It just make convert impure water to pure water. Pure water in the sense without microorganism, free from microorganisms. Okay, but in that our drinking water, there are some minerals, essential minerals should be there. If we start drinking distilled water, it will be very hazardous, harmful for our health. Like in many advertisements nowadays, you can see, they say the water is alkaline. They say the water is basic in nature. Okay, so it means it contains some kinds of minerals, which is essential for our body. Okay. So this is the answer for the question. Next is question number 5. Describe the process of neutralization with the help of an example. Now you know what is meant by neutralization. So let us see the answer. When an acid mixed with a base, then they react with each other to form salt and water, and they also release energy. That energy is nothing but in the form of heat. In previous video I showed you one activity, in one beaker I have added acid and base and then it became hot. So this process is neutralization process. Okay, acid and base, they cancel each other's effect. Like in our body also there is neutralization process going on. Do you know where it is? Chapter 2 you have learned, in stomach acid is released, food become acidic. Now the food, when the food move from stomach to small intestine, in small intestine receives bile juice, correct? And the nature, the chemical nature of bile juice is basic. So the food, the acidic food which come from stomach to small intestine, that food neutralizes. Get neutralizes when bile juice is added, because bile juice is basic in nature and it is very much essential. Okay, the acid present in the stomach should not move out of the stomach either upside or downside. Okay, neither in the small intestine nor in the esophagus. If it comes esophagus, we call it as acidity, correct? So let us see the example. NaOH, sodium hydroxide plus hydrochloric acid, HCl is hydrochloric acid. It gives sodium chloride, water and heat. Next question is true and false. So first, nitric acid turn red litmus blue. Nitric acid turn red litmus blue. What is it? Of course, it is false. Acid does not turn red to blue. Red will remain red. Blue will turn to red for acid. Nitric acid is acid. So first is false. Sodium hydroxide turns blue litmus red. Sodium hydroxide is what? Basic. And what do bases do? They turn red to blue, not blue to red, as it is mentioned here. So second is also false. Third, sodium hydroxide and hydrochloric acid neutralize each other and form salt and water. Correct. It's true. Correct. Fourth, indicator is a substance which shows different colors in acidic and basic solutions. It's also right. Tooth decay is caused by the presence of base. Tooth decay is not caused by presence of base. Second lesson we have learned that tooth decay is due to the acid released by bacteria which are present on our tooth. Okay. And to prevent tooth decay, we have discussed very properly, to prevent tooth decay we should brush properly with the toothpaste which contains base. okay, normally toothpaste have the base. So here are the answers. As you can see, okay. Question 7. Dorji has a few bottles of soft drink. Dorji is the name of a person. He has a few bottles of soft drink in his restaurant, but unfortunately these are not labeled. He has to serve the drinks on the demand of customers. One customer wants acidic drink, another wants basic, and third one wants neutral drink. How will Dorji decide which drink is to be served to whom? This is now critical. Okay, Dorji is, you know, having a restaurant and he has to fulfill the demand of customers. Okay, some customer want acidic, some want basic, and some want neutral drink. So how he will test? Let us see. Dorji can use litmus paper to check if the drink is acidic, basic, or neutral, and can serve the correct drink as per the demand of the customers. This is one answer. Now Dorji is having a restaurant, so he might not be having litmus paper. So what he can use? Whatever natural indicators available, like onion or China rose petal solution or turmeric, correct? So with the help of natural indicators also he can find out. So this is one answer which is on your screen. There can be other answers for this question. Okay, now question 8, explain why. You have to write the reasons. So first, an antacid tablet is taken when you suffer from acidity. So why an antacid tablet is taken when you suffer from acidity? What is the answer? Let us see. Acidity is caused when an excess of acid is produced in the stomach. Antacid such as milk of magnesia act as a base. Antacid is nothing but base. Don't get confused by the name antacid. Antacid means it is a base. It is not a acid. Remember this. So an antacid such as milk of magnesia act as a base and react with excess acid and neutralize its effect. So whenever a person suffer from acidity, it takes antacid, like Eno is antacid, milk of magnesia. There are many products in the market available which cure your acidity. So these products contain a base. Let us go to the second. B, calamine solution is applied on the skin when an ant bites. Now calamine solution contains base. Okay, when an ant bites, what happens? It injects formic acid into the skin, and calamine solution contains zinc carbonate, and zinc carbonate is base. So when ant bites, acid is secreted in the skin and it gives you pain. Now how you can get relief from the pain? You have to apply a base on it. Like you can apply soap. If calamine solution is not there at home, you can apply your bathing soap. It will give you relief. Okay, nowadays ant, this is the season of ants. Lots of ants will encroach your houses, correct? They will come at different places, correct? So if the case is there, if ant bite is there, you can get the relief with the help of base. Now let us see this third question. Factory waste is neutralized before disposing it into the water bodies. Why factory waste is neutralized? Because most of the factory waste contain acid, and if we dispose it directly into the water bodies, it will harm the living organisms like fishes and all into the water bodies. So it should be neutralized. Let us go to the next, ninth question. Three liquids are given to you. One is hydrochloric acid, another is sodium hydroxide, and third is sugar solution. How will you identify them? You have only turmeric indicator. Okay, so think for some time. You have three liquids. One is hydrochloric acid, another is sodium hydroxide, and third is sugar solution. How will you identify them with the help of turmeric indicator? Now here, turmeric indicator changes only for the bases. For acid, it remains as it is. Okay, so neutral, and for neutral and for acid, it will not change any color. Only for base, it will show to red. So there will be difficulty in finding whether the substance is acidic or neutral. Base we will identify. If the substance changes turmeric into red, we can say 100% sure it is red. It is basic, correct? Let us see. If you put drops of base on turmeric, then the red color will be obtained. If we mix acid with turmeric, then there will not be any change in the color. Here, on mixing turmeric indicator with hydrochloric acid, there will not be any change in the color. But when we will mix sodium hydroxide, we will get a red color. The sugar solution is neutral in nature, so mixing it with turmeric indicator will not cause any change in the color. Okay, you can add your own answer also in this. Let us go to the next question 10. Blue litmus paper is dipped in a solution. It remains blue. What is the nature of the solution? Explain. Now we know acid turns blue litmus to red and neutral solution has no effect on the litmus paper. As there is no change in the color, the solution can be either basic or neutral. Okay. Next. Last question it is. Consider the following statements. A. Both acids and bases change color of all indicators. B. If an indicator gives a color change with an acid, it does not give a change with base. C. If an indicator changes color with a base, it does not change color with an acid. D. Change of color and an acid and a base depends on the type of indicator. Which statement are correct? What do you think? Once again, C. First one. Second one. C and D. What do you think? Which statement is correct? Options are all four, A and D, B, C and D, or only the fourth one. The solution is correct is only D. Fourth option is right. Change of color in acid and base depends on the type of indicator. Okay. So here we have completed our exercise discussion. You have to solve it. You have to write in exercise notebook, in your science notebook. If you don't have notebook, you can write on a papers. And you have to send on my mail ID. Okay, yesterday I have given my mail ID. Yesterday I have given you the last date of submission of exercise. Still you have any doubt, any problem, feel free to call me. And there is also in your textbook extended learning. Good activities are there. Read, interesting activities are there. If you can do it, do these activities. Okay. So take care of yourself and use time properly for your study and to get you extra knowledge, more information, and stay blessed. Thank you.